What's up, my people? This is Showbiz the Adult. Let's talk about my guy out there in Dallas.
No!
No. Not that guy. Not.
No!
No, not that guy. Yes, that guy. Just a few days ago, he tweeted out something that was horribly sad to me. And the tweet is, I need a fight. I had to screenshot this tweet because it was just terrible. It's a terrible reflection of the current state of boxing. Why? Because this means that this guy has been reaching out for some time now and he cannot make a fight to save his life. What makes it even more sad is he's becoming the face of boxing. He is the biggest name in the welterweight division. It's not like this guy is the Aaron Pryor of the division, right? Just hard to beat, low reward, high risk. It's not like that. It's not like he's the Margarito and Sean Porter is the Floyd Mayweather. No, actually, Errol Spence is the Floyd Mayweather, and he can't find a fight. He can't buy a fight. That is really, really sad. No disrespect to Sean Porter, because I've heard him say on a few times that he wanted Errol Spence. But I'm hearing that Keith Thurman is now like his mandatory, and that's strange to me because Keith Thurman is out of shape. He's going to need a warm-up fight. What's Sean Porter supposed to do from now to when Keith Thurman is actually available to fight? Twiddle his thumbs? No. Errol Spence and Sean Porter should happen next. But according to Errol Spence, he can't buy a fight. Now let's talk UFC 229. Thank you to all of you guys who showed up to my live stream for my commentary. It was a great night. I love what you guys had to say. As far as the fight itself and the aftermath, what I did like about Conor McGregor is, I follow him on Instagram and he's saying, I'll be back. Don't worry about it. You know what I'm saying? He got more of a, he's taking the loss. He's taking the loss like a true champion. So, Dana White, we already know that Conor McGregor is Dana White's boy, all right? Now, the drama behind the fight, I'm not falling for the whole UFC is hating Khabib and his team right now and stuff like that. It just make it more dramatic, okay? If Conor McGregor can throw stuff at a bus and, hit Rose in the eye with shattered glass, and he can still have the biggest fight in UFC history, then this is just adding fuel to the fire, okay? So it's just a huge marketing ploy. I see them having a rematch only due to the drama, all right? Because the fight itself, Conor McGregor never had a chance, really. Not even on his feet. The most significant punch was landed by Khabib, okay? So what Conor McGregor needs to do in the rematch is kind of approach it the way he approached Nate Diaz. For some reason, Conor figured he can pull a Michael Johnson, walk Khabib down, and just throw his hands and do something with Khabib, and that just did not work. What he needs to do is fight off his back foot, not his front foot, throw more leg kicks to try to wear Khabib down, and expect a 5-round fight now. Okay, hopefully he can land something that's significant enough to hurt him and maybe TKO him. But outside of that, the approach should be to fight off the back foot, counter more, and if you're going to throw some, like initiate some strikes, they probably should be leg kicks or something like that, because you can't do nothing with Khabib when he takes you to the ground. Let's talk Anthony Joshua. The WBC just said that they support the winner between Deontay Wilder versus Tyson Fury to go up against Anthony Joshua next, okay? I'm not sure if that means that the winner between Deontay Wilder and Tyson Fury, is mandatory, to fight Anthony Joshua. I'm not sure if support means mandatory or something. I'm not really sure yet, but it's just been released early this morning that the WBC made that announcement. Now, I think that makes us a step closer to the fight between Anthony Joshua and Deontay Wilder. But like I said, personally, I think whoever wins between Tyson Fury and Deontay Wilder is the best, okay? It's just about getting those four belts from Anthony Joshua. I think Anthony Joshua is very talented. I love that he's in the heavyweight division. I love that he is so young and doing his thing. But from my perception, I think the best fighters in the heavyweight division are fighting on December 1st. So I think we are a step closer with WBC supporting the fight between the winner of Tyson Fury and Deontay Wilder to go up against AJ. But that doesn't mean it's a done deal, right? I mean, this fight between Deontay Wilder and Anthony Joshua is slippery enough. Somebody will find a way to avoid it, okay, to drag this out even further. But I think the WBC supporting this fight, or the winner between Tyson Fury and Deontay Wilder to go up against Anthony Joshua, makes us a step closer to the unification bout. Let me know what you guys think. Do you think Anthony Joshua will fight the winner between Deontay Wilder and Tyson Fury? Or do you think that he'll just, you know, fight somebody next and drag this on? How about Conor McGregor versus Habib? Do you think that's going to be a trilogy? It's definitely going to be a rematch. And as far as Errol Spence, who do you think he's going to fight next? I think it's just going to be just another brave soul out there just trying to make a name for himself. Let me know in the comments below. Don't forget to subscribe, share, and hit the little alert bell activity thing. Do you got to do. Showbiz the adult. I'm out. What's that? What's that? All boxing. What's that?